So last time I stopped at this node, but it seems like there is no way to save the game from the state, so I'll have to finish the baseball practice, I guess. Oh, and I already missed the ball. You can also try doing something, Kamikita. What were you saying? Here, I couldn't see. Whoa! Dodge is powerful. How did that happen? I don't know, I'm trying to hit this like middle of my bed, but I'm just catching the balls. Much stats. But still. At least I will be able to save this time. Okay. Rin's cats were getting together around her as she stood up on the pitching mound. She tried throwing them all away, but they kept crawling back up to her, and they continued it over and over. There was a shadow of a female student approaching Green from behind.
Oh, damn.
Maybe you want to join the practice. Green jumped back. Yosuke commented while careful fiddling with a speed gun. She's a member of the softball club that's practicing on the opposite side. This may mean trouble.
そういう問題じゃありませんことよ。あと、みたいじゃなくてトンボであってます。グラウンドとは、高みを目指し、汗を流すスポーツマンのためのトレーニングの場所。あなたたちのように、目標もなく、猫とじゃれ合ってるような人たちのためにある場所じゃありませんの。お分かり?
Didn't your subtitle in the opening said something about being a cat lover?
一応試合を目指しているらしい。らしい?まるでどうでもいい話みたいですわね。正直どうでもいい。She's
too honest.
なら、我がソフトボール部が伸び伸び練習できるよ。その発想はないな。Cut
her up there.
なつめり、我がソフトボール部までを侮辱しましたわね。
She clenched her fists and trembled with anger. There was a cat who didn't understand what was going on at her feet. He was brushing his cheek against her shoe. Bam. Another softball club kicked the cat? What the fuck? The kick sent the cat into the air, that's very dangerous. The cat spun around and safely landed on his feet. However, he cried weakly and lay low. A shadow fell over Rin's face. Rin slowly turned towards Sasami Sasagawa.
なんですの?
Rin's eyes were scaring her.
勝負だ!
I don't think that's your line, Kyosuke.
聞けばあんた。
2年でソフトボール部のピッチャーと4番を張ってるらしいじゃないか。え、ええ。リンと1打席勝負しろ。あんたが勝ったらグラウンドから去ってやる。
I think first we should probably ask that club member to apologize for just kicking the cat.
だがリンが勝ったら、あんたの後輩が猫を蹴っちまったことを詫びて、おとなしく自分の練習に戻ることだ。
この私が草野球に興じてる連中に負けるはずがありませんわ。ボールは軟式。バットは好きに持ってきてくれ。ササガワさん
returned to the opposite side of the field. With her eyes to the ground, Rin was standing still on the mound like a ghost.
ちょっと待てよ、キョウスケ。
Throwing away his bat, Masato dashed after Kyosuke.
今のリンがソフトボール部の4番に勝てるわけねえじゃねえか。
まあな、けど、俺はかけてみたいんだ。
何にだよ。
何か、 新たな力がリンから引き出せそうな、そんな気がしてる。
まんまみたいに行くかよ。そもそもストライクゾーンに来ることすら怪しいってのによ。
俺はスピードメーターの動作確認してるから、バスト、ジャッジとか。
サイミンス・サガワ came back with a few of her cronies.
素人がササミ先輩とサシで勝負してもらえるなんて、それだけでも羨ましいです。大きいのかっ飛ばして、格の違いってものを見せつけてやってください。
I guess their cheers will be a good motivation for Sasagawa-san.
準備は OK ですわよ。とっとと始めるとしましょう。
なんだ、リンの様子がいつもと違う
ぞ。 Oh yeah, she's fired up.
こいつは。
Who is that? Everyone was completely flabbergasted at what had happened.Sasami Sagawa had stepped into the batter's box and not even moved.
今の、何ですの？
130kg.
What? Kyosuke read the numeric value on his speed gun.
漫画だ。
ストライクコール
は？お、おう、ストライク！
ナイス。She completely failed to hit Rin's pitch.
今のさっきよりも早かったんじゃねえか。
I peered at the speed gun Kyosuke was holding. 135 km/h. It got even faster.
マサト、ストライクコール。
お、ストライク。
こいつは次で140超えるぞ。俺たちは奇跡の目撃者になる。
この私がかすりもせずに追われるものですか。
She shot on her grip.
ササミ先輩、先輩が負けるはずありません。
Even their cheers sounded mournful.
さあ来なさい。
Oh. This was a nice feint. She couldn't stop her swing.
チェンジアップ、しかもバカにしたようなすっとんきょうな冒頭。この私をここまで愚弄するとは。
いや、集中力が切れただけだ。
なあ、
サミスガワ got choked up。
おい、リン、もう一回集中力出して投げてみろ。
マサト pushed the stunned Sasami Sagawa out of the way and stepped into the batter's box. Although Rin threw many balls, in the end none of them passed the 100th boundary.Her best throws were between 80 and 88, which is amazing enough, though.
もう一回猫蹴ってみよう。
Don't. Masuda got kicked instead. How was she able to do it?
まあ、カジバのクソ力みたいなもんだろ。意識しては出せない力だってことだな。
Subconscious power? It just means those cats are really that important to her, doesn't it?
だろうな。
I'm sure that for Rin, the cats are a special existence above anything else.
とりあえず、さっきの魔球に名前をつけようぜ。
My strange friend left me at those words. Kyosuke, I wonder, does he realize his worth among us? Wasn't that just a fuzzball?
いや、猫の魂が宿ってるからな。ライジングニャットボール。
Wonderful.
どうだ。
Why are your eyes sparkling?Well, at least that's better than it was before.
もう一球。最後に投げた緩い球はチェンジアップという。正確には違うが、バッターに対して似た効果が得られたからそう呼ぶことにする。
After the practice ended, Kuda and I spoke with Rin. She lowered her brows when I told her that we were looking for a roommate. I guess Kurogaya didn't agree. She pointed at me and Kud. No, no, no. Kurogaya-san hasn't told you yet. It's not me. It's Kud who is looking for a roommate. I don't know how things work in a girl's dorm. Oh. Me? Well, before I knew it, Masato had already become my roommate. I guess the boy's dorm head did it on purpose, knowing that Masato and I were childhood friends. But I don't know how he found that out. It was probably a lucky guess. How did it work for you, Aspring? I stopped short of asking Green how she and Kut had been living when they were sharing a room, considering Green's bashfulness. She wouldn't be very good at getting along with someone she isn't familiar with. Oh, aren't there some particular rules for room sharing? Okay, thanks, I'll do that. I thank Trin. By the way, how come you and Dormhead know each other? She answered simply. Neko? That's all? Okay. Thanks, Rin. I started walking, but she stopped me. Yes? What's up? Okay. What? Okay, yeah. Got it, I'll tell her that. I nodded and said goodbye. I went to visit the dorm head alone. The role of the dorm head is to coordinate the group called the Dormitory Council, which all dorm members belong to. However, there is no election for that position. Instead, the previous head appoints someone as a successor. Oh, I haven't seen you anywhere before. And you don't have a name. The room which the dorm heads are using is next to the student council room. I had stepped in and asked the head of the girls' dorm. There were also a few other students working there. Is that so?
Oh, Fukin-chan! The papers are on the right table. Yes, there. Take them.
Well, this one was an opening. The female student, who was at the front of the show, bowed her head and left the room. She answered it while writing a document. Her job looked pretty tough. So will you give the permission? No, I'm not. It's for a girl, and I know.
Yeah.
I know.
Jodan.
She lifted her face and laughed with one hand on her cheek. Her laugh made it feel like she was much older than me, though she was just one year older. Yeah, that's right. Kudryavka, Nomi. Nodding, she took out a list of dorm members from a cabinet and started turning the pages. She soon found Kut's details and murmured. She told me that most girls nowadays prefer a single room to a shared one. I don't know. It's what she wants, but she's still busy with moving into her room, so I thought I could help her by asking about the technicalities. Thank you. I received a sheet of paper. Understood. By the way, what is this?
I see.
Thank you very much. You mean you want her to inform you? Okay, oh, by the way, I have a message from Rin, Natsume-san. Yes. She said the release date is next Monday. I'm not sure why she knows it.
正確にはニューカビかな。
そのあたりはどこから仕入れてくるのかな。
Maybe Kyosuke is working part-time there. She pondered for an instant, but soon crossed her arms and smiled.
まあいいわ。ありがとう。
You're welcome.I left the room.
Naoe-san!
As soon as I got out of the school building, I heard someone call for me. I turned around. She came from the school building. She was carrying paper bags in both hands. They looked quite heavy. Kudo, are you okay?
Hi!
She seemed to be staggering toward me in a hurry. That looks dangerous. She was waddling along.It looked like her petite body was controlled by the bags she was holding. And eventually... Oh no, she fell down. Okay. I went back to the entrance. Good, are you alright? I helped her up and took one of her bags. She was panting. These are quite heavy.Are they plates? Some items in the bags were wrapped in a newspaper. I wonder if the fall broke any of them. Oh, is that so? What's wrong, Kud?
Are you happy?
I'm fine, thank you.
Happy, thank you!
Even though she was speaking stiffly, she looked delighted that I had understood her greeting.
May I help you?
I think that's my line.
この場合は何でしょうか? Help me!
Doesn't that sound like I'm a dangerous stranger?
間違えました。Help you!
You're going to help me after all? Could rack her brain for a phrase to use for a while.But failed to find one. Then she made an embarrassed smile.
というわけで、こんにちは、ナオエさん。
Good afternoon, Kud. I thought you said that you were finished moving in.
そうなんですけど、おじい様が学校に来てくださったんです。それで、いろいろといただいてしまって。
What did you get?
マグカップとか、時計とか、万年筆とか、あとはいろいろな辞典を。
Why dictionaries?
もっと熟語とか言い回しとか洗練しなさいって。
You mean Japanese?
はい。日本語の辞典とか辞書とか集めるのおじい様の趣味みたいなもので、本が改訂されると買ってるみたいです。
Sounds a bit crazy.
日本語好きなんですよ、おじい様。
That's why this bag is so heavy, right? I lifted up one of the bags. I won't be happy if you have a fall and get injured. Hey, I asked the dorm head about sharing rooms. I handed Kud the papers the dorm head had given me. Kud bowed her head. No problem, I just asked her. She said there aren't any special rules. All you have to do is to find a roommate and here. It's for the dorm mailing list.It seems you can get information about the dorm from that. She wants you to fill it in and return it to her.
なるほど、わかりました。
Kud started reading the paper carefully. Anyway, let's move. I started talking.
はい。
I hope you'll find a partner.
はい、見つかるといいです。卒業までお世話になると思いますし。
Yeah, it's a long-term relationship.
なおえさんのルームメイトさんはどなたでしたか?
Like I said earlier, it's Masato. Masato Inahara.
いつも一緒にいる人たちの一人ですか?
Yep, that's right. Everybody calls us the idiot trio. If Kyosuke is added, it's a quartet. The quartet of idiots. Sounds awful.
ただいいのはとてもいいことです。
You think so? But Masato and Kyung are always fighting for silly reasons. Well, to be accurate, they might be just playing with each other.But getting involved in it is a real trouble, I added.
仲が悪ければトリオなんて呼ばれませんよ。
Kud clapped her hands and said that. Maybe you're right.
昔からのお知り合いでしたか?
I think you could say we are childhood friends, I murmured, retracing my past. They have always been with me. I looked at Akut and found that she was smiling. What's wrong? Did I say something funny? She kept on smiling while she shook her head. We were walking along the walkway leading to the dormitory. The evening sun projected our shadows on the ground. What are you doing? Kud was enjoying herself, stepping from one shadow onto another. You're playing with the shadows? It's hard to describe Kud's footwork as light. She was making unsure steps. The petite girl continued her play with the shadows. A street lamp, the edge of a fence, or trees. Sure, go ahead. Kud jumped up. Her tow-covered hair danced by me. For a brief moment, I caught a sweet scent from her. Kud looked at me and smiled innocently. That smile suddenly reminded me of my small trauma. The loneliness I had felt a long time ago. Yeah? Kud's voice brought me back to reality. Oh. If Kud didn't stop me, I might have fallen. Thanks, Kud. We went up the stairs leading to the entrance of the girl's dorm. At the entrance, I handed the bag to her. Oh, this is heavy. Can you manage? Kud bowed her head. Yep, you too, Kud. See you tomorrow. Just before going down the stairs, I turned around and saw Kud still waving her hand. After waving back, I descended the stairs. Shadows, huh? I tried to remember the last time I had been playing Shadow Tag with Kyosuke and the others. Well, I'm all alone now. Another day, another battle, it seems like. Seeking an opponent, I wander around the campus. And it's Kengo again. What happens if we skip battle? Oh, he actually gives you an item. Okay. Because we won't be able to beat him, probably, but if he gives us enough buffs, we'll be able to... To beat someone else. And... What did he give us? Bento. Okay. I'm not sure why he says it looks good on us. And he leaves. Okay, Masato and Rina fighting again. Let's just listen to the results. And Masato won again. Another battle. Again, Kyosuke and Komori. Let's also just listen to the results. And Komori has beaten him this time, which is just from time to time, depending on the weapon. Whew, I guess this is enough wondering about. Yeah, it seems like we're back to the usual evening mission with Rin. Rin prepared her earpiece and headed to the dorm. We have to give her proper backup this time. Oh damn, it's not working. They all just have the similar wavelengths. It's just one, like, that one time when we played Phasmophobia and just decided to ignore one person in the global comms while he was wandering in an asylum. That was funny. It seemed to be a complete coincidence that Andrin and Masato had carried out our dialogue. What? Oh, and you like muted the output on her earpiece. In other words, this was his doing. Shouldn't you have told her? But the door of the veranda opened up. She came by. A girl was standing there with a glow in her eyes. Kengan threw the cell phone to Masato. The scapegoat. Rin jumped into the room and kicked Masato's head while he was pressing the cell phone against his ear. I knew this would happen. He said without hesitation. And she bought it. I also think that's a little hard.
Spy だったらな。そういう時もあるも
ん。何？そうか。じゃあ、今日だけだぞ。
よし。
That's all, Kyosuke. She's planning to fail for his persuasion. Anyway, she resumed her mission. By the way, Masato was still lying unconscious behind us. Well, first I... her. But what if she acts like she did yesterday? Who's that? Ah, that voice. Saigusa? Oh yeah. Her voice gradually grew fainter, just Rin retreated. Rin sure isn't good at getting along with people who are acting too friendly. Throughout the microphone, we could hear Seigusa's unquiet voice. Finally, she couldn't be heard any longer. It sounds like she's trying to catch up with Rin. Why? Why such a thing all of a sudden? Wonderful, it's like, you know, in the sport, in that game when you try to go pacifist route, you just need to sing and dance when greeting new species to just establish a friendly relationship, and Justine will be going around the campus using the tambourine to initiate dialogues. After that, we would often hear the sound of the tambourine. But that has nothing to do with her mission at all. Oh. It happened again. I started to wonder if Sagawa-san was going out of her way to come and meet Rin. Even she stumbles. She couldn't deny it.
What? 気に触る音ですわね。なんだ。
何かタンバリンに嫌な思い出でもあるのか。
小学校の6年間なぜか一度もタンバリンに触れることができなかったとか、そんなことはどうでもいいんですよ。
Really getting her backstory。
それは哀れだな。貸してやろうか。
私の過去に土足で踏み込まないでくださらない。
何ですかササミ様、また夏目ですか。
お前たちやっておしまいなさい。
I felt like Sasagawa-san has gotten a little friendly over there.
これを使うとどうなるんだろう。何かに火がついた。
ササミ様、使わせていただきます。ササミ様の決して折れることのない心を感じます。
Then this will be a tough fight。
ササミ様、私たちにお任せください。いや、どう、しまった。いや、これでどう。
行くわよ。
いや、終わり。いや、しまった。いや、ミスった。えい、
えい、
ササミ様のお手を煩わせるまでもありません。
こんな尻の青い下級生にすら勝てないなんて話にもならないですわね。
Damn. Wait, wasn't that the different from the original mission?
どれも等しくミッションさ。
I'm sure I'm just getting tricked. And so the night went on.Riki? Riki? A voice is calling me. Someone is pulling on my hand. Who is it? Kyosuke? No, Ryu? The world is turning round and round. An earthquake? No, it's just someone shaking me. Then I woke up.
Riki, 大変だ。
Rin, what happened?
Riki, いいか、よく聞け。
Yeah?
えらいことなんだ。
Yeah.
私も驚いた。
Yeah.
ブルッと来た。
Uh-huh. Just tell me what it is already.
いいか、よく聞け。
I'm all yours.
学食のおばさんが。
What?
誰もいない。
That shook me. Why?
わからない。ただ、朝練を置いた奴らが困っている。だから、手伝ってくれ。私一人では無理だ。
We need to figure out what this is about. However, as Rin said, rather than just thinking about it, preparing breakfast for the waiting students should be a priority. She dragged him out of the bed, dropping him onto the floor with a loud sound. There was a lot of old cooking equipment in the cafeteria's kitchen. You'd normally hear the staff's lively voices from here, but now their absence was making this place feel much wider and quieter.Well, what should we do? A good idea. Although the breakfast is different every day, there is always just one item on the menu. We should be able to figure out what to make by checking out the ingredients. The cafeteria staff are missing. Dunno. But there is people waiting for breakfast, so Rin is trying to get us to do the job in their place. I wonder if that message on the cat's tail was, like, just...Only noticed that they wanted to go somewhere, so find someone to substitute them. She commanded us loudly while gathering ingredients on the table. Eggs, lover, hijiki cooked soy sauce, and filleted salmon. There was a big rice cooker we'd be able to steam rice in. Also, we found a big pot filled with miso soup. I think we only need to heat it up and it can be served.So will you please lay out the plates, Masato? And then portion out the food onto them equally. I handed him a large container of hijiki. Rin heated up the salmon in the microwave oven. It took 2 or 3 minutes for them to get warm enough. I powered the miso soup into a soup well and carried it out to the cafeteria. After that, I dished out liver and eggs onto plates, setting them on trays. Beside me,Rin was preparing the salmon to be served by adding a slice of lemon to each portion. Our task was a fairly simple one, but the number of hungry students was too large. It was obvious that we needed more people to get the job done right. Hyun-go, who had finished his morning practice, asked with a wondering look. Perfect timing, give us a hand.
よくわからないな。どうしてリキが学食の手伝いを。
I explained what Rin had told me.
そういうことか。わかった。待っていろ。
He ran out of the cafeteria. After a while, he returned with Kyosuke. ピンチなんだってな。They rolled up their sleeves. Dependable guys indeed.Around 8 o'clock, there were only a few students left in the cafeteria. Whew, we got through it. And she nodded. I was completely worn out since I wasn't used to this kind of work. Just the thought that class was waiting after this was depressing. Rin brought me a breakfast tray. That made me realize that I hadn't had anything to eat yet. Haven't you already eaten? No.Let's split it then. After a moment's consideration, she nodded, picking up two pairs of chopsticks.
ちょっと待て！俺の朝飯はどうなるんだ？
You're a big boy. You'll be fine.
おだちんやるから、なんか買ってこい。はい、100円。
安いな、おい。
Well, let's visit the faculty office next break and ask what happened to the cafeteria staff. She nodded.During the next break, Kut came over to me, and I think we'll listen to her in the next episode. So, thanks for watching, see you next time.